Good afternoon, guys. My name is Alina Shaltsova. I'm an immigration attorney from New York. In today's video, we're going to cover DHS policy change with regard to work rates. We're going to talk about travel using land border or ferry to the United States and opening of the border, and under which conditions you may be able to come to the United States starting November. And I'm going to provide you some interesting update regarding immigration reform plans. So stay tuned. Please, if this is your first time here, subscribe to my channel, like and share this video, and let's start. Another important piece of information. DHS, so Biden administration, is changing the way visitors from Canada and Mexico will be allowed to come to the United States starting early November. Instead of prohibiting travel by land or ferry, visitors will be allowed if they have proof of vaccinations. First, they're going to allow those who are essential workers and vaccinated. Unvaccinated essential workers will be allowed as well, but starting January 2022, everyone who would like to come into the United States will have to demonstrate that they are fully vaccinated. There may be a question as to which vaccines will be accepted as proof of being fully vaccinated. And currently it's vaccines that are approved in the United States, Pfizer, Moderna, Johnson & Johnson vaccine. And from what I understand, also vaccines that are approved or recommended by the World Health Organization. Of course, before you make plans to travel, you have to check with the CDC website to make sure that your situation is going to be acceptable. Why? Because, for example, in Canada, there were cases of mixed vaccines and it may present a problem. We're going to see what CDC is going to tell us about this and how DHS is going to regulate this situation. Another important piece of information. New York just recently joined California, Colorado, Maryland, and Virginia in criminalizing deportation threats against people who are non-citizens. Very important. Why is it important? Because again, a victim of such a crime may and should report it and may potentially qualify for a U visa status down the road. And finally, the most interesting news. I have some updates regarding immigration reform or potential action that Democrats may take in order to improve lives of millions of immigrants in the United States. So if you recall, I had that video on parole. Now we have a little bit more details about what Democrats may actually propose. They may propose parole for those who resided in the United States since 2011. And that parole would be given first for 5 years with an opportunity to be renewed. Parole would allow you to work in the United States, be saved or be rather protected from physical deportation, and would probably come with an opportunity to file for a travel document. Directly, parole will not lead to a green card or to citizenship. However, we'll give you an authorization to work and ability to travel. According to Community Change Action leader, this is exactly what Democrats have in mind. We're not sure yet if they will step forward with this plan. They're also talking about overruling the Senate parliamentarian decision on immigration plans that were presented before her. We're going to see how it's all going to unfold. But for now, I think parole is one of the more realistic options that we may see happening. Do not know if it's going to happen, but if it will, of course, I'm going to share with you that news. I'm going to provide more details as to what may happen as soon as we receive them. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this video, please like, share, subscribe to my channel, and I hope to see you soon.